Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between William Potter and Matthews. This game was played in London in 1868. William Potter had white pieces and he started with e4. Matthews played e5, d4, e takes on d4, the most played move, and now c3, going for the Danish gambit. Black to move. c5 was played. D takes on c3 is the most played move, and then white usually plays knight takes on c3 or even bishop to c4. Back to our game. We have c5, knight to f3, d6, bishop to c4, knight to c6, and William Potter castled kingside. Black to move. If d takes on c3, knight takes on c3, and it only helps white with the development. Although black is a pawn up. Back to our game. d3. Rook to e1. William Potter just ignores the pawn on d3. Bishop to g4. Pinning the knight. White to move. What would you do? Perhaps queen takes pawn comes to mind. Do you agree? William Potter played e5, intending to open the e-file. It makes sense, doesn't it? Knight takes on e5. White to move. This is now the critical position of the game. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Please pause and find the best move for white. William Potter played an unbelievable move. And the move is knight takes pawn on e5. Is this a blunder? In the legal trap, white knight is on c3. Black to move. Matthews happily captured the queen. What now? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? We know that in the legal trap, bishop takes on f7, and after king to e7, the knight jumps to d5. Checkmate. But white knight is too far from d5. So what did William Potter have in mind? William Potter played bishop to b5. Check. King to e7. How to continue the attack now? William Potter played bishop to g5. Check. f6. If king goes to e6, then knight to c6, discover check, and after say king to f5, knight takes queen, king takes on g5, knight takes on f7 check, and white is winning. To avoid this variation, Matthews played f6. How will you continue now? Now knight to c6 doesn't work, because after king to f7, knight takes queen, rook takes knight, and black is even better. So what is the best move then? William Potter played knight to g6. Discover check. Double check. King to f7. The only move. White to move. White played a move. And that was the end of the game. The move is the obvious one. Knight takes rook. Check. Mate. Is that a brilliant miniature? Or is that a brilliant miniature? What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.